Good evening, everyone. How are you today? So thank you very much for coming today. Today I'm going to talk about one of topic. What is the topic? Appreciation. Why I chose this topic? We know this coming Thursday, big celebration. Thanksgiving Day. So I was thinking today I want to give some message about Thanksgiving Day, because everybody are excited, they are making so many plans to celebrate this special day. Last week when I was in MCC in my English class, we discussed about this topic. All these students, they shared their experience about Thanksgiving, what they did last year, and also what they are going to do in this year. These students, because this is my first Thanksgiving Day, I don't have any experience. So all these students, what they told, they are going to make some foods. Also, they are going to visit their parents, family, friends. That is their plan about this Thanksgiving Day. But there was a volunteer teacher, and he said, what I do Thanksgiving Day every year with my niece, nephews, and my children, every day we are going to grocery in Thanksgiving Day. And we are buying so many groceries, so many items with my kids, with my nephews. And after that, what we do, we are going to food pantry. And we donate all the foods to the food pantry. After that, our whole family, we are going to some place and we are having some foods, and we all together discuss what we did today. And we are discussing about the Thanksgiving Day, and we are enjoying that day in some restaurant. So every year we are doing like this, that teacher told us. I was thinking, it is a wonderful idea. Because in Sri Lanka, we have a New Year Day. We are going to celebrate every April. Same thing, all the family who around the country, they visit parents, they are enjoying, they are making foods, they are playing so many games. It is one of the big traditional festival in Sri Lanka. In this Thanksgiving Day, I think same idea, all the family all together, they are doing something special. So, think that teacher and his family, what they do, they are doing something special with their kids. So many people around this area, they are living without food, without house, without friends, family. So also you can do something different to celebrate this beautiful day. What is my topic? Appreciation. Everybody like this word. Think, thank, thanks and appreciation. Appreciate. These two word has two big idea. Every day we are tell thank you. Someone helped us. We always tell thank you. But when we tell I am really appreciate, it has very deep idea. Sometimes that word come from our heart. So that's why I said everybody like this word. It is very powerful word. I think everybody know one of famous book. Its name, one of two authors, I think they live in this country. That book's name, Chicken Soup for the Soul. Who know? Yeah. So I found some story from that book. This is a Sri Lankan book. One of friend sent to me. It has beautiful stories. So in this book, they include one of story from that book. So I really want to explain that story to you. That story explain about that topic. What is the story? There was a school. One day, one of new teacher came to that school. Usually, we can remember our school period. Usually, teachers are come to classroom and they are taking our textbooks, just something they give us. But that teacher was thinking, today I want to study something different. Today I want to teach something different. Then what he did, firstly, he taught his students about appreciation. How you show your appreciation within your heart. Then how can you change the people within that appreciation? He taught his students firstly that idea. Then what he did, he took three flowers, that all flowers made by, you know, ribbon, blue ribbon, that all the flowers made by ribbons, rose flowers. He took three flowers. And also he gave that flowers students too. Then he said, this coming week, I'm going to make a suggestion. This coming week, we can make some name for this coming week. What is the name? Next week, our appreciation week. What do you have to do? I gave three flowers, all of you. After school, what you have to think in your life, someone helped to change you. Someone really helped to come this position. Go your home, think who changed your life, who helped your life to change. And you already have three flowers. What you have to do, go to that person, give one flower and tell why I give this flower to you. Then already you have another two flowers. What you have to do, give that two flowers to that person. Okay? Understand? And he tell. Then tell that person who changed your life. Give that one flower to other person too. That is that teacher's activity. Then everybody went to their home. There was a one boy. He went to his home and he was thinking, who changed my life? Suddenly he could remember in that area was a poor man, young boy. But now, he is working one of company as an executive director. He was very poor, but he worked very hard to study. But finally, he reached his goal. That little boy went to meet that young executive director. Then he gave one flower to him. He asked, why you give to me this flower? He said, you know, you changed my life. I always focus you. You work hard. You study very well. But now you are in good position. Always I follow you. So you are changed my life. I am really appreciate you. That's why I gave this one flower to you." And that young boy, he felt very emotional because he was thinking, "This is best award in my life." And also that little boy gave other two flowers to him and told, "Now what you have to do, someone change your life. Think who changed. Go to that person, give one flower to that person." And also he has other flowers too. Same thing, give that other flowers that person too. So then that little boy went his home. That young boy who is executive director, he was very surprised. He was excited. Then he was thinking, "Who changed my life?" He could remember his boss. Then he went to meet his boss. He told, "I want to talk with you." Sometimes in our life, so many bosses, they are usually tough. They are not friendly. But some people are very friendly. So, but his boss, that young executive director's boss, was very friendly. He told, "I want to talk with you." "Okay, you can talk with me," that boss told him. Then, what he did, he has two flowers. He gave one flower to that, his boss. "Yes, why you give to me?" He said, "You are a very creative person. You are very patient. Also, you work very hard. You are friend with us. You are good boss for us. You always guide us very well. So I'm always follow you. I want to really appreciate you. That's why I gave this flower to you. Thank you very much your kind help for my life," that young boy told. That boss, he was thinking he got so many awards in his life, but he was thinking, "This is best award in my life. This is a very innocent award for me," he was thinking. Then that young man, now he have already one flower, he gave to that boss, "You know my boss, what you have to do, you have to think who changed your life. Go to that person, give this flower." Then that boss also was thinking, "Who changed my life?" That day was very late. He was very busy. So after work, he went to his home. He was driving and he was thinking, "Who changed my life?" He could remember his little son. His son, when he was very little, his wife was die. After that, that father and son, between son and father, don't have enough relationship. So that father don't have enough time to spend with his son. He was thinking, "I really want to appreciate my son." Then he went to his home. He took little rest and went to his son's room. Then what he did, he gave his flower to son and told, "You know my son, I'm really sorry for last couple of years. I wasn't a good father for you. Sometimes I blame to you why you got bad result in your class. I blame to you. We don't have enough time to spend our life. So I understood. I always work for you. That's why I was busy. I'm really sorry, but I'm really appreciate your that patience. You work very hard." Then that situation was very emotional. Both cried. After that, that son told, "You know my father. Last couple of years was very hard to me. Sometimes I was very sad, I worried. But tomorrow I plan to commit it to suicide. Before that I want to write a letter. What I going to do? How about my experiences? And after that I plan to commit it to suicide. But I really understand who is my father. I know your love now. You really loved me. And then that son and father, they understood about their situation. That father saw his grateful for his son. So this is the story. Think that teacher told beautiful story. He taught beautiful message to his students. That is that all the people connected to each other. But finally, they save a life. So I want to say, think about our life. So many difficulties, so many troubles, problems. I think you can remember. But that all the time, sometimes maybe your parents, maybe your sisters, brothers, your friends, or husband or wife, someone helped you. Someone tried to change you. What you have to do this coming Thanksgiving Day, you have to think, who changed my life? Who really helped to me to come this position? I really want to appreciate that person. So you can do it. You have to think. It will be a beautiful Thanksgiving Day for you. So try to think this message. Have a beautiful Thanksgiving Day. Thank you very much. Have a good night.